All right, I'm going to do the hat for this young man. The hat is his dad's old hat, and I dipped a cloth into wax, and for the loincloth for the Indian piece that I did called the Eagle Dancer, and I kept some of the excess that I had left over. And what I've done is I cut it into a real thin. I don't want the full top of the crown of the hat. I want it to, so I can shape the crown with clay in it. But I wanted something to give me a brim. The brim, you know, so it looks like it's hanging loose on his head. It's a little bit big for his head, so, you know, it would fall down on his face if he was wearing it that way, but he's wearing it on his head like that. So that's that way, and I stapled where it crosses over and lays on top of the other half once I established the size of the hat size I wanted to do. Now, let's show you something else. Here's what I used for the armature of the brim. That's the flat part of the hat that goes around. I found that using file folder paper is the best stuff for armatures for the brim. Okay, I've cut out the brim. I don't know how much I lost because I think my camera just died of battery power and I just had to plug it in. And I combined the cloth that was dipped in wax and put it on the center of the brim. And I can already tell you that this side here is wider than this side, so I'm going to do a little trimming, but first I'm going to get this attached to this by using clay. All right, now all I do now is take some of this soft clay that's been heated up underneath the lamp, and I just start covering this side of the brim. One of the things I found about using this kind of material, this file cabinet type of folder, and it's just a common, ordinary file cabinet folders. It's like one of those green, you know, coated paper folders. And the one thing I've found is the clay sticks to it real good. Now I want to even up the edges, so just go around. Yep. I'll just cut it out. And now the brim of the hat is just a little more evenly spaced around. It's the same length all the way around, same width from the crown out to the edge. Now, if you notice on his head, he's got a little bit of his head showing here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to cut that out. Never done this before, so it's going to be a learning curve for me as well. I want to put a flat piece of clay on there. You can't have it hollow all the way up inside, because if you do, it makes it hard to cast. You got to make it shallow, the space between there and the clay. All right, I've placed the hat on. I've formed it a little bit. Just, you know, like you would normally form a hat. There's going to be some rips in it because this material I'm working with is a little old, but that's okay. Like I said, the hat has to have some kind of character to it. Because every cowboy, you can tell who a cowboy is by just the shape of his hat. Because every hat has a personality that relates to the guy that's wearing the hat. I'll shape that a little bit better once I get the crown. I'm going to give the young boy, his father, a kind of a old style crown. Like I said, everybody has their particular style for their hats, and this is a kind of a pinched in the front and slanted towards the back type brim crown. Actually, it was the type of crown that Kevin Costner wore in the movie Open Range, this kind of crown. I don't think I'm going to put a hat band on it. A lot of the working cowboys, they don't really wear hat bands. They might wear a hurricane strap or a stampede strap, where that's what would be a chin strap that hangs off the hat and keeps the hat from flying off their head in a windstorm or a stampede.